Hi, I'm Jesper Pedersen from KDAB. You're just joined, possibly, programming with Qt and QML. You can look forward to, well, this is the last episode, at least recording this round. We are talking about proxy models. We have seen how we can implement our proxy model. I've been going on and on how proxy models are a great thing because they separate your responsibility. But they can also be slightly troublesome, especially when you have a bug somewhere deep down in your proxy model stack. But to the rescue is our good friend GammaRay. And let me just add one final time a link to GammaRay underneath me here. GammaRay is this free tool from KDAB. You can just download it and use it in your product right away. I'll start my application over here. My application, oops. Just run the application and it comes up like this. And I'll go to my shell. I will start GammaRay. And GammaRay comes up asking, what do you want to attach to? And I'll attach to this one here. Thank you very much. So here is my GammaRay. Here is my GammaRay starting up. And I will now want to see the models. We have a plugin in GammaRay for seeing the models. It's grayed out. No, it's not because I'm so stupid. I don't know how to retake a shot. I know how to stop and figure it out, but I just wanted to show you what a really confused developer looked like. Just so when you see yourself looking like that, why is the model grayed out? You will know exactly why, because I'm telling you now. See, the way that GammaRay works is that it listens to your application very, very thoroughly. And among other things, it listens to all the Q objects being created. And when it sees a Q object being created, it will ask it by going through the meter object system that we've talked about so many times throughout this video series. It will ask it, hey, dear Q object, are you a subclass of Q abstract item model? And if you are, good, then I know that I'll show you there. But GammaRay that I'm running now didn't find a single one of those because I attached my application or I attached GammaRay to my application. So at the time that GammaRay came around and started listening, all my proxy models and all my mods had been created already. Now, there's two solutions to this. Solution number one, well, there's three solutions. Solution number zero, cry for help and ask KDAB to help you. Okay, the second solution is to start GammaRay not attaching, but launching your application, because then GammaRay gets to listen even before your application is up and running. And now you can see my models over here. I do have them. So now I have my model section. That's solution number one. Solution number two, and let me just show you that one too. So if we go to, let me just make this slightly smaller, go to main.cpp. In main.cpp, that is where I created my models here. And notice that my models here are top level Q objects. They don't have a parent. GammaRay is clever enough to actually go and talk to all of those top level Q objects that it knows. So it would go and ask the view, for example. It knows about that one. It knows about another one, namely our application up here. So if I just gave GammaRay, or gave the Qsort filter proxy model the application as a parent pointer, and if I just go and check my video filtering here, it has this constructor that's parent equals null pointer, so that's good. My duration sort blah 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 proxy model also has a parent. So if I do that and let me just run it now, just needs to compile. And here's my application. And now when I attach GammaRay to it, attach to this one, yes, please. Then our models are back in business. So here is our models now. Now, okay, let's see. We have three models. Here at the top, I have my playlist model. But so much for trees that grows downwards. In the real world, trees goes up. So this is really at the bottom. So at the bottom, I have my playlist model. On top of that, listening to that model, we have our video filter sort proxy model. And then we have the duration sort proxy model. Have I been telling you like 1 billion million times already? please do add Q underscore object to your Q object subclasses, even if you do not have signals or slots in there, because if for no other reason, it adds the object name. And that's nice, because had I not had Q underscore object in those, the models would still work. The models would still be visible in GammaRay, but they would just say Q sort filter proxy model, Q sort filter proxy model, and Q abstract item proxy, Q abstract item model, rather than playlist model, video filter model, and duration model. Okay, so we can see the playlist model here. And here's another one of me going like, Yes, I was like, here's my model content. Weren't I supposed to see the real model over there? Well, actually, let me just move the cursor. Well, wrong focus. Let me just move the cursor over here down. You can see there are actually stuff. And if you look over here in the sidebar, you can see that it actually figured out that the title here is, the media type is audio. The title is Enjoy the Silence. The producer is Depeche Mode. Duration is 276 seconds. And they are string and integer and so on. So it does actually work. The reason why it doesn't see anything here is that GammaRay looked at the display role, and that's what it shows there. Remember, I told you that the model view framework is somewhat obscure simply because that it comes from the days of widgets. And in the widget, we had the queue list view. The queue list view will not go and ask for the role that is the media type role and the title role and whatever. It'll go and ask for the Qt colon colon display role, Qt colon colon decoration role, Qt colon colon edit role, and so on. And that's what it asks. So to make this slightly more useful, and I know that I'm ending on the lowest possible note, because when you start this up, I'm sure that it will show you stuff here, because my good friends in KDAB, I complained to them already that didn't show anything. So I'm sure that they are working night and day to go over here and find another role to show you. But on the odd chance that they still haven't done that, when you see this video, let me show you how you can adapt it. And if for another reason, it will give you some learning of how this works underneath. So I'll just go over in my code again. I'll go to my playlist model, the implementation of the playlist model, and simply add this line here, case colon Qt colon colon, no, not case colon, case Qt colon colon display role. Now, whenever Qt comes around and asks for the display role, I'll just give it the title. In my QML level, I'll not use that at all. I will actually never call my data method with that from the QML. But I have another audience on that model now, which is my GammaRay. And my GammaRay will, let me just start up here. GammaRay will come and ask for this. And now you can see here, model content, enjoy the silence, farewell, the matrix, and the big bunny or whatever it was. I'd like to send out a thank you to everybody in KDAB that has been participating in developing these videos. Nobody named, nobody forgotten. I'd like to thank you for watching all of these videos. And it's not too late. You know what I'm going to say? You have two options. Well, let me just say them both. Do subscribe to our channel, and do, for my daughter's sake, give me a thumbs up, will you? And until next time, if we ever should meet in real life, remember, I'll sing you the proxy model. Have a great day.